All right, welcome back. We are back on our bullshit one more time today. We're going to continue our look at the advanced rule set for one-page rules, the stuff that you get for the $5 or $10 Patreon monthly subscription. So we've looked at a couple of, we looked at terrain and we looked at missions. Today we're going to look at the next couple parts of this book. The same housekeeping as always. We're not going to be showing any of the actual rules for this. If that seems interesting and the concept is interesting, go give them $5. So this next section, we're going to cover extra actions. This doesn't really have anywhere in the core rulebook that I can use as reference for the back. So, no, that's not the one. Yeah, that'll work. That'll work as a background. That's not distracting at all. My God. So extra actions. We have hunker down, defensive stance, covering fire, focused fire, heavy charge, stealth move, and overwatch. Those are extra actions you get on top of your regular action choices. Now, that is a lot of this does what you would think it does. It just has the rules for exactly how to do it. So you can hunker down and make your enemies take minuses to hitting you with shooting till next turn. You can do a defensive stance where they will take minuses to melee against you next turn. You can do covering fire. All right, look at that. All right, so covering fire, which if you take minuses, you shoot a difficult shot, and if you're successful, you have a 50-50 chance of making it so that the enemy unit that you're firing at has to take a morale test, which could shake them. There's focusing fire, so you give up some movement for some additional shooting. There's a heavy charge, where you get an addition to your melee, but only if the charge distance is between 3 and 6 inches. Stealth move, where you make a move and enemies get minuses to hit you until your next activation. You essentially hold it, so then you can try to shoot a unit that moves. So instead of shooting during your turn, you kind of hold it and try to shoot at somebody when they become an eligible target. So this is an interesting array, and obviously they tell you you can use some, you can use none. It's completely customizable to whatever it is you're doing. There's a couple of these I think are really solid and I think really will help elevate your game. And there's a couple of these that are kind of cheeky. But they're good. They're good. This is a good set of advanced rules. This gives you some growing space to do with your game. This gives you some options for what you can do if you want it to be a more tactical game with more options. You know, if you're playing an army that really hunkers down and focuses on a speciality, some of these extra actions will make you better at what you do and help you cover up for the things you don't do as well. All right, so let's take a look. So hunker down lets you get out of being shaken, which is, you know, that's important anyway, and then gives you a bonus to do something. Now, this is super handy if you're going to need to get out of shaken anyway, which a lot of these do, but it gives you some bonuses. Let's see. This one specifically gives you a minus for your enemies to hit you. Sorry, I misunderstood it and I reread it while I was looking at it. So your defensive stance, it's another one you can drop to get out of shaken, gives your enemies a minus to melee until your next activation. Covering fire is a nifty one. Covering fire lets you hit on a difficult hit. So you hit on sixes. And then you also have to be successful in a follow-up roll. But if you are, then the enemy that you did the covering fire to will have to take a morale test and will run the risk of becoming stunned from failing that. So that's a super handy way if you need to lock some part of the battlefield down. Focusing fire lets you stay put and get better to hit within a certain range. Heavy charge lets you do a charge between 3 and 6 inches for bonuses and melee. Stealth move lets you move your regular amount and then your enemies get a minus to hit you. And overwatch, which is an interesting one, and I think that's a difficult mechanic to work in here, but I think they did a decent job, is you just stay idle and then when something else moves or shoots, you get to react to it. So, you know, it's about giving you options and giving you situations where you might not have had an option and now suddenly you do. All right, so now we're going to take a look at, they have rules for open versus solid buildings. So if you've got like a bunker or a facility that is in your terrain set, this has rules specifically so that you can do something with it so that matters. So open buildings have one or more openings that can be used to place models inside. Solid buildings do not. So why would you want a solid building, and what would a solid building give you? Solid buildings come with an additional set of rules here where, instead of just being a large line of sight blocking terrain, they give you options for if it represents a building and you can put X number of units in it. And they have examples for how big of a building would be, you know, like a shed, a house, a fortification. They have the variant rules for if you're shooting into or out of a building. And of course, they have the building being destroyable and collateral damage to it. So you can make the fact that it's a building matter and make it a, you know, not just an automatic win for the player that's defending and hiding inside the building. You can give a reason why you would want to be able to damage or destroy the building and give a bonus to the person attacking. So it's not just, oh, hey, I'm hiding in the building and now everything is better for me. But that does give you the first of a few options we're going to go over in this series that lets a piece of terrain matter more than simply blocking the line of sight that your enemies have. And that matters because then suddenly your battlefield feels alive. It matters. Suddenly it matters what is happening and where the different pieces of terrain are placed. It's one of those things that's often overlooked in games. You know, you look down at a battlefield, especially if you get into the habit of doing this a lot, and suddenly it's like, oh, well, that's the rock that keeps me from being able to shoot unit B at my full capacity. Next we have, and the last for this video, is random events. Now I'm not sure if we're going to get through all these in this video, but we're going to start them. This is an interesting thing to do. So the way that this works is you essentially every round, at the beginning of each round, you roll a dice, and on a certain roll you trigger an event, a random event happening. You roll two dice and determine which one you get. First you roll to determine the first number, and then you roll to determine the second number. So it'll tell you on your list here, you know, number one, the first number you roll is a D3, the second number you roll is a D6. So if you get a 1 and a 6, you're going to go get number 16. There are obviously then 18 different random events that can occur. So each round you have a chance to have something funky happen. Now this is a wide array of things that can happen. There is The Walking Dead, where a unit of zombies just shows up, quality 5, defense 5, attack 3, slow zombies just show up and try to attack whatever's closest to them. There are things like anti-grav boots, or a random unit. So you pick a unit randomly from your army, they get to be plus D3 on advance and plus D3 on rush. It's just, they just suddenly have anti-grav boots, just, you know, because and why not? And while this is definitely something I think that is a more geared towards your advanced players, your players who have a lot of experience and really have a fundamental understanding of the rules and how to make sure that everybody's having fun in a game. And this is definitely not the most balanced thing by its very nature. Anytime you have random number generators affecting battlefield roles like this, you are always running the risk that you are going to go wildly in favor of somebody and wildly, you know, opposed to somebody else. But that's okay, because, you know, there's something to be said about surprise. Now we have this new thing to deal with. I'll give you one more example of the 18. So we're going to look at flash grenades. Select one random army. Enemy units get minus one in melee when attacking units from that army until the end of the round. Just surprise, we all have flash grenades. It's such a wonderful bit of chaos, and if you are confident and competent in your games, or you're coming from an advanced system and you've gotten the core stuff down, this is the kind of chaos that really makes for memorable moments, because, like, you're doing really well and everything is going really well. Suddenly you guys have flashbangs, then suddenly there's a group of zombies and they just showed up and they just happen to be where they don't need to be, and now you're in trouble. But that'll cover us for Dorkness Inc. today. Thank you so much. Have a great day.